HTML defines the structure of web page content, whereas CSS styles the structure and makes it look beautiful. This is what our finished website will look like at the end of this tutorial. CSS is super easy to learn. We will start by drawing a basic wireframe, which we can then reference when styling our page. Feel free to follow along with a pen and paper. We want a header on our web page, with the header containing our logo on the left-hand side and a navigation bar containing links on the right-hand side. The main content will go below the header, centered horizontally on the page. This section will contain a heading, an image and some text. Below the main content and at the bottom of the page is where we will place our footer, which will contain a copyright notice. So in HTML each of these boxes will act as containers, for us to place related content. When designing your website layout it can be helpful to think of everything on the page as belonging to a grid, with this grid consisting of rows and columns. The HTML tags and style specifications used for this layout will be as follows. Our header will be made with the HTML header tag and will have a blue background, spanning the full width of the page, with a height of 75 pixels. This tag will contain two direct children. A div containing our logo and a nav tag for our navigation. All text within the header will be colored white and centered vertically. The main content section will be constructed with the HTML main tag, having a fixed width of 700 pixels, a top and bottom margin of 50 pixels and will be centered horizontally on the page. This tag will contain three direct child tags. A header tag containing our post's title, with the title centered horizontally. A div containing our image and thirdly a div that will contain the post's text. The text will have slightly larger than default font size and line height for readability. Lastly, our footer will use the HTML footer tag, with a custom gray for its background color, also spanning the full width of the page to match our header, with a height of 100 pixels. As mentioned before, the footer will contain our copyright text. The text's color will be white and it will be centered both vertically and horizontally within the footer. Create a new text document and save it as index.html, as this is typically the name given to the homepage of a website. Note that the correct file extension here is important. Also, if you don't have an image stored locally on your computer, we recommend downloading from the internet and storing it in the same directory as your newly created index.html file, as we will be using this image later in the tutorial. I'm going to use Atom in this tutorial, but any text editor will do. So let's add our HTML tags, then our head tags and we'll have the title, our website. Next add the body tags with the header, main and footer tags. Inside header, add a child div and nav tag. Inside the header div tag add an anchor tag. Add a hyperref attribute with a forward slash as its value, as we want to redirect back to our home page, when our logo is clicked, and add an ID with a value of logo. Also, set the anchor tag's inner text to our website. Now jump to the nav tag and add an unordered list with three list item elements as children. Inside each list item, add an anchor tag and leave the href attribute value empty as we currently don't want these links going anywhere. Set the inner text of these anchors to be one of about, blog, or contact. Hop into the main tag and add a header and two div tags. Inside the main header tag add an h1 tag with contents of first blog post. In the first child div tag add an image tag and set its source to the image we stored earlier, in the same directory as our index.html file. Add width and height attributes of 700 and 480 pixels. In the second main child div tag, add three paragraph tags. Our paragraph tags will contain lorem ipsum placeholder text. In our footer tag add a child div. Inside this child div add the HTML copyright entity. Ampersand. Copy. Semicolon. Followed by the year and your name, like so. Notice how all these tags correspond to the ones we wireframed earlier. Let's save our file, open it up in our browser and as you can see. Although all of our content is here, it still needs styling as we haven't added our CSS yet. Create a new file and save it as style.css. Make sure to put this file in the same directory as your HTML and image file. We now need to define a relationship between our HTML and CSS, which is achieved with the link tag. Link tags go in the HTML head element. Notice that we said head and not header. Careful not to mix those up. Define the relationship of the link element by adding a rel attribute and set its value to style sheet. Also add a type attribute with a value of text forward slash CSS and finally an href attribute with a value of style.css. we were able to use a relative path as the href's value because our HTML and CSS files are in the same directory. So with CSS, first you select an element that you want to style. So if you want to style the HTML header element, your selector would be the element's name. In this case header, followed by opening and closing curly brackets. Everything inside these curly brackets, also known as the declaration block, would then be applied to anything on the page with the header element. Remember that we wanted to set the background color of the header to blue, with a height of 70 pixels. Let's add a height property and set its value to be 70 pixels, and also add the background color property with the following hex value. Hashtag 4267b2. Note, hex values start with a hash. Also, we used a hex value here instead of just using the value blue, because we want a custom shade of blue. If we save our CSS file and refresh our browser, we can see that our header style was applied twice. First time is to the top level header element, and the second to our main element's child header element. Let's give our topmost header element an ID of page header, and wrap the direct descendants in a containing div. Now let's update our CSS header selector to match the element with the ID value of page header. Notice that CSS ID selectors start with a hash, whereas CSS class selectors start with a period. Notice now that only the first header element with our page header ID has a blue background. The elements containing text in our header are each displayed on their own line. But our scope required that they all be displayed on the same line. To do this, we need to change the display from a default value of block to inline block for several elements. Let's select the logo ID, nav element, and the list item elements. We can select all three of these with one declaration block, by comma separating the selectors. Now position the nav element 0 pixels to the right. Note then, when using a value of 0, the unit of measurement is not required, as 0 will always be 0. When viewing in the browser, we can see that our navigation list doesn't seem to be positioned in the right place. This is because both our body and UL elements have default margins. So, let's clear all default margin and padding values from all elements on our page by adding the wildcard selector and declaration block at the top of our CSS file. Setting the margin and padding values to 0. We will then select this div element in our CSS file by using the page header ID child combinator div selector. Note that the child combinator is the greater than symbol, also known as an angle bracket. Here we are setting the height to be 100% of its parent, in this case 70 pixels. A display of flex allows us to align our items vertically. In this case we are centering them. A position of relative changes our nav element to set its absolute position, relative to its new parent div element. The margin property here leaves the top and bottom at 0 and changes the left and right margin values to 25 pixels. Let us now use the anchor selector and within its declaration block set the text decoration to none and color to white. This will remove the underline from our hyperlinks and change the font color to white. So, we've just realized that we actually made a mistake with the placement of our nav, list item, anchor elements, in a text. That was quite a mouthful. Let's quickly fix that now, by jumping into our index.html file. Correct the misplacement of our about, blog and contact text and save the changes. Then jump back into our style.css file. Let's save our file and refresh our browser. Notice that our logo's font size is a little bit too small. So let's fix that. Let's style the element with an ID of logo, increasing both the font size and font weight and by adding additional fonts to the font family property. Basically, the browser will select the first font available to our machine from the comma-separated list of fonts that we have provided. The last elements we will be styling within our element with the page header ID are the list item elements. So let's do that. Before styling the main content of our page, we will first style our footer. Our footer element has a height of 100 pixels. The display properties, flex, value here allows us to both vertically and horizontally center our child elements, using the justify content and align items properties. We are also setting the footer's background color to be that of the hex value, 2d2d2a. The last section in our HTML page that needs styling is the main element. We are setting a width of 700 pixels in the main element, with a margin of 50 pixels on the top and bottom and auto for the left and right. These left and right auto values will center our main element horizontally on the page. We are horizontally centering the H1 text and specifying the font we want. To style the image, we are setting its top and bottom margins to 12 pixels, with the left and right set to auto. Lastly, our paragraph element has its font size and line height increased from the default sizing. And we are specifying what font we want used if it's available to the end user's machine in order of precedence. The leftmost fonts have higher priority than the fonts listed to the right. This is what our site should now look like, after adding CSS. To recap, first you select what you want to style with a CSS selector. Then you declare what styles you want to apply in the declaration block. It's a good idea to indent for easy readability, with each rule ending with a semicolon and each rule being written on a new line. Selecting multiple elements is achieved by comma separating them. The space combinator selects nodes that are descendants of the first element. Whereas the child combinator selects nodes that are direct children of the first element. There are three places to put your CSS. 1. Written in a separate CSS file with a file extension of .css, which is what we did in this tutorial. 2. Written in between an open and closing style tag, which resides within the head element. 3. Written inside of an HTML tag, also known as inline CSS. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions regarding this video, please comment down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Until next time, wishing you all the best, from the team at Module 8.